Thanks, Jude. And now it's time for another...
Will it work?
Will it?
I taped this sign up really good this time, Rachel. It's not going to fall.
Oh, now it works. And it's fancy.
It's fancy. That's my work, my friend. All right, you ready to go?
Oh, yeah.
We got some music today.
Now we're ready.
We are. Look at all these ingredients
for
this.
What is going on, Pete?
Well, it's a density experiment.
Okay.
And it does look cool, doesn't it?
It's
right
very
here.
Pretty.
Yeah.
What is all this?
Well, all different ingredients. Let me show you how you have to do this, because I have a picture, because I wanted to get this experiment started before we actually got it together. It takes a while. It takes a while to get all these ingredients together. You can see all of the ingredients, about 4 ounces in each one of these different measuring jars or containers, and they're honey, corn syrup, maple syrup, milk, dish soap, water, vegetable oil, and rubbing alcohol. Now, when you put the first few ingredients in, you have to put it right in the middle. You don't want to get it on the side. However, when you get to the water layer, you want to put it basically along the edge so that it sits on top. What this is density.
All right.
Different things have different densities.
The denser items are on the bottom?
Exactly. Heavier items go to the bottom. So what would be on the bottom, the honey or the water?
I'm going to go with honey.
Yeah, there you go.
And it looks like honey, too.
Yeah, it does.
So, yeah, that was easy.
So
what's
next? That's honey. And then, well, just as I said, honey, corn syrup, and on it goes.
Oh, you said that already?
Yeah, I did, but I turned you out again. No, you're exactly right. I didn't make myself clear.
Look at how pretty that looks.
It does.
In HD.
And what you do is you put food coloring to color the water and the rubbing alcohol. This is rubbing alcohol. Why don't you put it right along the edge, if you would. And now, usually, you put lamp oil on top. Okay. I got this from the SteveSpanglerScience.com website again. The guy is great. If you want experiments, go to his website. And what we do here on Will It Work is we just try to figure out if these really do work as well as they say. This one last night didn't work this well. So I realized something. You have to let it sit for a while. It's one of those where you can't just put each one in.
Oh, and then, that's why you had to start early.
Yeah, let it layer.
That is beautiful.
Particularly the dish soap.
Which
and
is
milk.
The blue one, right?
No, the dish soap is right here, the yellow one.
Oh, okay.
See, it's the yellow dish soap? Yeah.
Okay.
And the milk, that layer, I think the densities are just a little bit too close because you can hardly see the milk. But other than that, it looks a lot better
blue?
Than it did much. That is, oh, man.
Well, I didn't know that there would be reading involved here. I thought you would just know these things.
Well, that's water.
I thought, okay.
Now the experiment, part two. Now we put different things in here
There's
to see.
More?
Yeah, there is more. Rachel, go ahead. You put this bowl in. Where does it go?
What happens to it?
Goes all the way to the bottom.
Okay, can we do something else?
All right. Why don't you put this
tomato,
cherry tomato, in there? See
do
if
I
that goes all the way.
Do I just plop it in? Do I have to be gentle?
Yeah, you can be gentle. Does it go all the way to the bottom?
It does not.
Nope.
It stopped midway.
Here's a popcorn kernel. Let's see where that goes.
It bounced right here on the blue. Mm-hmm. It bounced and it went up.
Pretty amazing. This is a little bead, plastic bead. Let's see where that goes.
Oh, that sat right on top of the milk.
And now this is a Monopoly die. I think that's a little bit heavier.
Oh, that's going down, slowly.
Almost to the honey.
It's going to rest on the honey.
We have a ping pong ball. That won't go anywhere.
I knew
anywhere.
That would float.
Yeah, you pretty much did.
Yep.
And then we also have a soda top, which we're just going to get in there and get it.
Look at the dye down there. That is the coolest
floating
thing
in there.
Ever.
And now you do have an opportunity to see where these things are. It is a little bit cloudy. That's one of the problems with this experiment. But it does show density.
This
it is a great
problem.
Experiment.
Oh, I
you
give
like it
10 beakers.
Well, we only go to 5. So I'll give it 4 out of 5 beakers. And thank you very much, Rachel Monick. We've done it again. And it really did work.
I love it. Because not only is it fun to do, it's pretty.
It is. It's very pretty. Just look at that.